now that we've done Peng, Lü, Ji, and An on the left side, now we turn and do the same movements on the other side with the right arm forward. So follow me. First, with me facing you. After you finish the last repulse monkey, drop the hands, turn the waist, holding the ball with the right hand on top. Then step a little to the corner, the toes go forward, and pang, left arm round, right palm down. Turn the waist, twist the forearms, and yi, roll back, shifting, turning, twisting the waist, extending the arms. The right hand comes by the ear to the left forearm, and ji, cramming. Then extend the left hand over the right hand, and ji, cramming. Then extending the hands forward at shoulder level, palms down. Shift back, let the hands drop down to the dantian as you raise the toe. Then drop the toe and shift forward. An. Fingertips at eye level, shoulders sinking, elbows dropping. Weight on the left leg, but the knee is not past the toe. So the transition from here is to shift your weight back first onto the back leg. As you do that, you're going to turn in the left toe, pivoting on the heel. So from an, shift forward, shift back, turn in the left toe, so you're pigeon-toed. Turn the left toe in as far as you can comfortably go. And then you can even make a tiny adjustment to go a little bit more. You may get a bit of an ankle stretch if that's okay with you. So from here, shift back, turn in the left toe, weight on the right leg. Then shift back to the left leg, and holding a ball with the left hand on top, drawing in the right foot, like so. So that's the turn from Pan, Yu, Ji, and An on the left. Now shift back, turn in the left toe, pigeon toe, and weight on the left leg, holding the ball with the left hand on top. Then step, place the heel, then the toe, a little bit to the corner, not out on a tightrope, but a little off to the side, and the toe still towards that wall. Then shift and palm, warding off right. Now the right arm is palm in at shoulder level, the left hand is palm down. Nice and relaxed and loose. Just let the wrist sit. From here, the hips are square. Pang, the energy is a little bit toward the diagonal, just a little. So the feet line up here, and pang will go that way. So again, from half, shift back, turn in the left toe, shift back, hold the ball with the left hand on top, step out a little bit to the side or to the corner, place the toe, and pang. You'll notice I turn in my left heel again, because I didn't quite get it around far enough the first time when I started the turn. So this is pan. From here, I twist my waist to the right, rotate the forearms, and then shift back, rolling back. I turn the hips, I twist the waist, and I allow my hands to relax, drop down, and then extend, not pulling my shoulder back, but letting it go out pretty much in front of the center line. The right arm is round as if you're hugging a tree, or a logger, and here. Then the back hand comes by the ear, then comes to the forearm, and shift forward. Ji, cramming. Then extend the hands, shift back, as you raise the toe, and drop the hands to the dantian. Then drop the toe, shift forward, and an, or push, also called press sometimes. Now let's do it on the other side. From the last repulse monkey, we drop the hands, turn, hold the ball with the right hand on top, then step, and pan. Turn the hands, turn the waist, and yi. Right hand comes by the ear, and ji, nice and relaxed. Extend the hands, shift back, and an. Now shift back, turn in the left toe as far as you can go. Draw within reason. Then drop the right hand, holding the ball with the left hand on top, drawing the right foot. Then step, and pang, word off right. Turn the waist, turn the hands, and last repulse motion. Drop the hands. Hold the ball. Step. Pan. Yi. Qi. Han. Shift back, turning the toe. Holding the ball with the left hand on top. Step. Very good. Yes, I think so. I think you're doing fine. Keep up the good work.